everyone. I'm Simeon Lancaster. Welcome to In Depth with Tommy Media, a show that explores campus issues that affect you. According to stopbullying.gov, a significant amount of bullying happens on the playground or bus. But what about abuse in college? Experts say data on bullying in college is less prevalent. However, a 2013 study by the Alberti Center for Bullying Abuse Prevention says 70% of students who were bullied in elementary or high school continue to be victimized in college. Today, we will explore what bullying in college looks like. I'm joined today by teaching developmental psychologist Tanya Bach. Thank you for being here.
You're welcome.
According to stopbullying.gov, bullying among younger ages is frequently physical and verbal. What does bullying in college tend to look like?
Less physical, more verbal. In fact, we would say that it might actually take on more of the characteristics of what we call relational aggression, and that's using different aspects of relationships, manipulating relationships to exclude others or harm or damage others. So examples would be spreading untrue rumors, calling names or spreading names, untrue names about others, gossiping, things like that.
Why don't we hear more about this issue?
Well, the other studies have shown that if you look at bullying in elementary, in middle, and high school, and college, that there is a pretty general decrease from about middle school is when it's actually most prevalent, less so in high school and even less so in college. And what happens in college is that they move away from home. Students move away from home, and you don't have the same social circles. The social circles also become more complex, such that you don't have, in every college situation, you don't have small cliques and the larger crowd structure as you would in like middle school and high school, mm-hmm. that can create some of those bullying dynamics.
Okay. Many students in college, it's a stressful time for them, even without the social bullying. How can these situations impact their lives and their studies?
Oh, it can impact them greatly, absolutely. For someone who is being bullied, they're in a new environment. They're trying to make friends. This is especially prevalent at the beginning when they're just transitioning to college. If they are being bullied, they aren't finding the connections and are actually receiving really negative feedback about social connections at school. So it can be a really make or break situation for whether they decide to continue at that school or college or leave.
Okay. College students, they don't have the same support system of parents and teachers that younger students in middle school and high school have. What support is available for victims here at St. Thomas?
Oh, there are two sources of support. One would be the mental health and counseling services here on campus. They're a fantastic source of support, and you can call during the day, I think, any time to try and set up an appointment, and especially if it's something that's urgent. And then also the Dean of Students and Residential Life are well prepared to deal with these kinds of situations.
Thank you. If you have a comment or an idea for a future in-depth segment, tweet it to @TommyMedia. Thanks for joining us. With Tanya Bach, I'm Simeon Lancaster. We'll see you next time when we go in-depth with Tommy Media.